Would that hold true for the fact that, you know, a lot of the policymakers in Africa now are thinking about how can we invest regionally?
And well, that is a different thing. Amongst the things that Africa needs to do better on, one of the top things, in my opinion, is to start trading with each other.
Yes.
Historically, African countries, possibly for reasons that old colonies are guilty of causing, they spend far too much time fighting with each other.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of evidence from international trade theory, huge amount of evidence, that international trade is a win-win.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously some sectors lose, but it's a net gain for both sides.
Mm-hmm.
And it is quite encouraging to see the beginnings of some of this. But I'd say that is a bit of a different issue than having a financial sensor.
Yeah.
Because if you do stuff like that, the finance will come.
I mean, we're looking now, what you're talking about now in terms of the sort of intra-regional trade is
It's
about, probably about 12 to 15%, depending on whose numbers you believe of.
What was that 10 years ago? Probably half or less, I
yes,
would guess.
Indeed. One of the key things I'd like your view on is intra-African investment,
mm-hmm.
which actually is only about 5% of total FDI stock in Africa. And now, you know, there's a move to get the pension funds, the African pension funds, who are projected by 2050 to have in the region of $7 trillion worth of assets.
Yep, yep.
And that's less than 10 of them.
Yep.
And the sovereign wealth funds. How do you think you know, the market should evolve so that pension funds and sovereign wealth funds in particular feel more comfortable investing across border in the continent?
So I was at another event in London recently with a bunch of academics about African infrastructure.
Mm-hmm.
And this topic was at the core of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there were sort of three, again, rather basic issues.
Mm-hmm.
The first of which, I'll repeat an aspect of what I've already said. If policymakers do credible things, the money will come.
Mm-hmm.
They shouldn't spend too much time on trying to build some kind of notional framework for investment. It's like, show credibility, show consistency, show compliance acceptance,
mm-hmm.
and make your proposals about whatever the investment are credible.
Mm-hmm.
So that, assuming that would happen, the second thing I would say is I think the world's sovereign wealth funds, as well as maybe some private family offices, are in a really fortuitous position mm-hmm. relative to other investors, because they're not subject to the same regulatory madness that has become so fashionable in the West in particular
mm-hmm.
For the past 5 years. Western pension funds can only invest in stuff of a very high credit rating.
Yeah.
So that eliminates immediately most of Africa.
Yeah.
And I think the problem there is that policymakers, in a regulatory sense, are always fighting yesterday's war.
Mm.
And today they confuse liquidity with safety.
Yeah.
And I think there is a grave need to relax
mm-hmm.
some of those regulatory constraints, because I think for many of these kind of investors, in principle, the notion of investing in a Pan-African fund, in principle, is pretty high.
Yeah.
And then the third thing I would say, also contradicting myself slightly, of course, is there is a lot of capital going into private equity funds.
Yeah.
And I find myself personally thinking that the VC early stage opportunity is probably where the better returns are going to come from.
Mm-hmm.
Problem for a lot of people with that is you don't need so much capital, and a lot of the big guys can't be bothered with that, which gives great opportunities for those with smaller capital to deploy, I think.
Definitely.
Doing business in Africa. You can't afford to be without Africa Investor.